how do you prepare the pitch over the summer?
Okay, so the last home game of the season takes place, and the very next day we're in, we try and reduce the surface to an absolute minimum, scarifying, we scalp it, and then it's a case of preparing the surface ready for seeding, and the seeds are drilled into about 2 centimetres, crisscross pattern across the pitch to ensure maximum coverage. Then it will be top dressed, and this year we've put 2 tonnes of root zone and 40 tonnes of sand over the top to level it, so the seeds are growing in a flatter condition as possible. It's usually vertical drained, but due to the conditions this summer, the ground's far too hard, so the vertical drain will wait until the ground softens up. And then it's just a case of getting enough water to make sure the seeds germinate and produce a decent surface. Water has been the toughest thing this season. At times we've had 4 hoses going at the same time, and it's still not even touched the surface. Just a lot of rain, but the seeds have taken well. There's not too many bare areas, so yeah, it's not too bad.
What is the most rewarding aspect about your job?
I think when you see opposition players, staff and fans walk through the turnstile and stop, get out their mobile phones and do that at the corner. I think that for me is enough, because they're obviously blown away, so I'm happy.
So which fixture are you most looking forward to being played this season?
There's a few local derbies that we haven't played for a while now. Chesham, obviously, Ware, Waltham Abbey, Potter's Bar, they're all in and amongst us. I'm going to miss the Spartan derbies, the Hoddies, the St Mags, because they're always tasty. But, you know, it's a chance for new teams, new rivalries, and, you know, chance to visit a few new grounds. So,
finally, what's the worst possible thing that could happen to your pitch?
Away teams winning on it. Simple.